Hello everybody and welcome to this tutorial. Today I will show you a little bit more stuff that you can do with Nmap, but more importantly than that, I will show you a tool which you can use to assign a physical location, namely a city, to an IP address. It's relatively precise, it's relatively good, but the downside of it is that you can only make 1000 queries per day. Which is still very reasonable. I mean, 1,000 queries per day is a pretty good thing. However, if you're doing some sort of mass scanning or something like that, it won't really help you. You will need to go online and download the libraries for that. But 1,000 is a very good number, and let me just show you how it actually works. So here I have a command. This is the command that I've used to scan scanme.nmap.org and to get some information from it. So it's curl space ipinfo.io/, and then you get an IP address here. It's a curl script, so let me just copy paste that here. And this is the command, curl. This is the argument that you are passing to it along with the IP address. Once you press enter, it queries the server, and there you go. You have an IP, and you have a host, you get a host name as well. You get a city, it's Vermont. Its region, it's California. Country, US. You even get some coordinates here, organization, postal code, and so on and so forth. So you get some really useful information here in regard to an IP address. But as I said, the downside is that you can make only 1,000 queries per day. So you're not doing anything illegal here or anything of a kind. You are simply querying a database somewhere in the world to give you specific information on an IP address. You could have done this by simply typing on the net who is. However, I wish to teach you how to do these things in the terminal so that you would be less dependent on the browser or things of a kind. Anyway, let me just go ahead and clear this. Now, what I wanted to discuss with you today are some external resources which you can use in combination with Nmap. Nmap has a wide variety of scripts that are applicable to it, and then you will be able to use Nmap in order to scan for particular vulnerabilities on the servers elsewhere in the world. So just go ahead and open up your browser. Okay, so I have this website, scanme.nmap.org, open here. And on that website, there is a link. It's nmap.org, and then some link here. You can just copy paste this if you wish, or something of a kind. Just read through it and then navigate over on their website. But it's not really that hard. Look, I'm here on Nmap's website, and I have a list of categories of what sort of scripts can I run with Nmap in order to scan for particular vulnerabilities. So I have there are 490 scripts, which is a lot. So I can, for DOS, for denial of service attacks, those sort of vulnerabilities, for exploits, for, I don't know, external, for brute forcing, for authentication, etc. Anyway, let's just go and click on one of them. Pretty much any will do. It's not a problem. I'm going to go ahead and click on vuln, some general thing. And now I have all these things here. So if you're wondering, well, how can I bypass firewall rules? Well, simply use a script. It says firewall dash bypass, detects vulnerability in NetFilter and other firewalls that use helpers to dynamically open ports for protocols such as FTP and SIP. So this is going to help in a good amount of cases. You can go ahead and let's open it up in a new link, in a new tab, sorry. And once you click on it, you'll get the exact syntax how to use it. So example usage. It gives you the exact syntax. There is nothing different that you need to do here. Instead of lesser than, target, greater than sign, just type in the IP address, and that's it. Literally, that is the only thing that you need to change here. Just type in, copy-paste this command, so just copy it, and then just change the last thing into the IP address that you wish to scan. Now, I'm not going to go through all of them. As I said, there are 490 scripts. We will be using some of them, however, in the later tutorials where you will get some clear demonstrations once we actually start attacking particular services and start exploiting their vulnerabilities. However, again, I won't go through all 490 of them because the course would be ridiculously long. But you can go there. You can go to the Nmap website, find this. So look, you have security tools, security lists, scanners, etc. There are so many resources here that you can use, and I strongly advise you to go onto this website and check it out. But just take a look. This is probably the most important part for you and for everybody on this website is the availability of these scripts. So just take a look at what they do and what you can do with them, primarily because you can save yourselves a ton load of time by just conducting a scan for certain types of exploits. If I click on exploits, it gives me all sorts of exploits. So for example, if I'm attacking a very secure file transfer protocol, just read through it. It explains in great detail what it does, and if you click on it, it's going to give you the exact syntax which you need to use. Literally the exact syntax which you need to use. Right next to it, you just type in the IP address of whatever host you want, and that's it. There are no changes. There is nothing else that you need to do. You just copy paste this and change the name here. Anyway, I'm just going to go and scroll up. And then I have yet another website that I wish to show you. It's called ExploitDB. So just type in ExploitDB and the first site that pops up, Exploit Database by Offensive Security. Click on it. This is pretty much one of the largest databases out there in regard to vulnerabilities. You can find them all in one place here. They are literally here. There are some very nice wireless tricks that you can do here, reverse shells, privilege escalation, pretty much everything. We will be using this site extensively in the follow-up tutorials in other chapters as well, but I just wanted to mention it here primarily so that you can explore it a little bit. And I strongly do advise you to do it. Just go through the website. For example, take a look at the router that you are using. Just see what sort of a router you're using. See what sort of a router was provided to you by the ISP provider, and then go ahead. Click on search in the upper right place in the upper on the top menu. It's in the right. I'm selecting it now. So just going to click on it once again and search for the vulnerabilities of your home router. See what you can do with it. See you can look at it by a port. There is a free text search, description, order, their platform. Look at how many platforms are down there. If you don't know what platform it is, just try a free search thing. Type in the name of your router, type that in free search text, and it's bound to give you some vulnerabilities because pretty much all the home routers have more vulnerabilities than they should. So that is the task that I leave you with. I want you to open up this website, Exploit Database, find the vulnerability of your router, of your home router. Figure out which one it is first, but usually you can do this by just looking at the box of the router. And once you've done that, you can we once you've found the vulnerability, there will be a description how to use it. Try using it, try exploiting it. If it fails, and it probably won't, because all you need to do is copy paste things into the Linux terminal. And we're going to do a lot, and we're going to do some demonstrations later on along the way as we do some more complex stuff. But before we do it, I want you to try it. And if you have any questions, post them in the question section. I will be more than happy to not only answer them, but also to help you through the process as well in terms of instructing you or something like that. You don't need to pay anything extra for that. I will do it gladly and help you out. But please give it a shot. Try it first and then continue up with the tutorial, see what I do, then perhaps you can fix your technique and improve yourselves. Before I leave, just one more time, over here you have scripts that you can use with Nmap to detect particular vulnerabilities. Just click on it. Once you click on it, you will get the exact syntax. All you need to do is change the IP address and type in ExploitDB. Use this website extensively. It is very good. There are lots of vulnerabilities on it. Pretty much all of them are located there. It's completely free. You don't need to pay anything for any of the services that I have mentioned here. Open, free, anybody can access, no registration required. And with that, I will leave you today, and one more time, I will urge you to try it yourselves and then continue on with the course where I do it myself, and then you can see the particularities and the fine details of how it is done. I bid you farewell, and till next time.